Let's talk about what are the why do we need subnet mask at all? So we understood that given a subnet mask and an IP address, if I AND them, then I'm going to get the subnet ID or the block ID or the network ID, right? So subnet mask is sometimes also called as network mask. Okay, so don't get confused between these two names. Network mask or subnet mask, both are same. Now, given a subnet mask and the IP address, if I do bitwise ANDing, I am going to get something called as subnet ID. This is nothing but the subnet ID of the subnet to which this particular IP belongs to. Okay, that is one thing you should understand. And second thing is, given this subnet mask, it is going to be very useful in the routers, right? So router has the main decision to do is this. Let us say router is having all these interfaces, and if any packet comes into a router, it has to decide about which of the outgoing paths it should use, right? So for that, it should understand what is the destination IP address, what network, which means whether the destination machine is either in this network or in this network or in this network or in this network, which means subnet mask is going to be used by the router to find out which way to direct the packet by using this kind of manipulations, right? So that is one thing you understood. Then in your computer, if you open that IP config or if config, you are going to see some few things. One is IPv4 address. So IPv6 is also there, but one is IPv4 address, which is nothing but the IP address, 32-bit IP address we are talking. So if you have to get connected to the internet, you definitely need this. So who is going to give you this? ISP. Your ISP is going to give you IPv4. Along with this IPv4, your ISP is also going to give you default gateway IP address, one thing. And he is also supposed to give you subnet mask. What is the subnet mask you should be using? Okay. And one is DNS. So these four things will be provided by your ISP. One is your IP address so that you could be identified, and second is default gateway, which is nothing but the default router connected to your network, and third is the subnet mask, which is nothing but the subnet mask you should use, and the fourth is nothing but DNS, which is used to convert the domain name into IP address, right? So let's take this why to use this and why to use this and why to use the DNS. So default gateway is nothing but this is the router using which you are connecting to the internet. You know how to, why do you need IP address, you know why do you need DNS. Now my question is, you are not a router, then why do you need a subnet mask at all? We have seen that routers need subnet mask to find out the direction, but then you are not a router, then why are you using the subnet mask at all? The reason why you are using the subnet mask is, you can think of a network like this, and let us say all the stations or the hosts are present here, and the network is now connected to a router, and this is the default gateway I'm talking about, default gateway, okay? And the other side, there is internet. This is your network, right? And in your network, you are here, and other stations are here, okay? So now, whenever you want to send a packet to a destination, you should know two things. First of all, what is the IP address of the destination? So for knowing the IP address of the destination, you could use DNS, or sometimes you could directly ask the destination through some other means and you could find out its IP address. After finding the IP address of the destination, you should know whether the destination is in your network or in the other network. The reason is, let us say you are A here, and your destination is B here, right? I'm saying that you should know whether the destination B is inside your own network or outside your network, which means somewhere here. So why should you know the difference is, in case if the destination is in your own network, you can directly send a packet to B. In case if the destination is in some other network, you should send the packet to the router, and the router is supposed to send the packet to B. So that is why even a source or any host is also supposed to have subnet mask. So using subnet mask, what we could do is, let us say IP address of A is IA. See this? Let us assume that A is here and we don't know about B. Then what will IA do is, let us say at A, IP address of A is IA and the subnet mask of A is SA. and B, IP address of B is IB. Standing at A, I'll not know what is the subnet mask of B, and we are not supposed to know also. So A knows its own subnet mask, and A knows its own IP address, and A knows B's IP address somehow, either by DNS or by some other means. Let us say A came to know about the IP address of B. Now A has to decide whether it should directly send the message to B in case if B is in the same network, or should it send the message to the router and then ask the router to send the message to B, right? So these are the two cases which it has to distinguish. So in order to do that, A is going to do this. A will take its own IP address and AND it with its own subnet mask. Then it is going to get network ID of A according to A. Why according to A? Because it is the subnet mask of A. Now, if A takes the IP address of B along with the subnet mask of A, and if it ANDs it, then A is going to get network ID of B according to A, which means according to your subnet mask. So whatever your subnet mask shows you, you are going to see it. That might not be the right answer, but still, A according to A, its own subnet mask is this one, and according to A, according to A, its own network ID is this one, and according to A, B's network ID is this. In case if these two are equal, which means network ID of A according to A is equal to network ID of B according to B, then A can be sure that B is present in the same network and it can directly send the packet to B. In case if A is having subnet ID of let us say these two are different, then A can think that both are in the different networks and A will send a packet to the router. Okay, understood that? So let's take an example and let's see how to put all these together. Let's say a host A is having its IP address IAS 200.1.2.10 and its subnet mask of A is 255.255.255.128, right? And we don't know what network it is. Actually, this is not class C. Yeah, it is actually class C, but then it could be even possible that this is classless CIDR and it is with slash 25, right? That is also possible. Now A wants to send a message to B, and about B, A knows only one thing. IP address of B is 200.1.2.130. So that is what B knows. A knows only the IP address of B. Now A wants to send a message to B. Now A will be in a network. A is in the network, right? And now A is connected to a router, and this is the internet. Therefore, the location of B could be either B could be present in its own network or B could be present in the internet. In case if it is present in its own network, it can directly send it. Otherwise, it has to send the packet to the default gateway, and the default gateway will forward it, right? So it has to understand which one. But then by looking at the IP address, both are like same, right? 200.1.2, 200.1.2. Therefore, if you just look at the IP addresses, you might think that both are in the same network, but it is not really true. Both are not in the same network. The reason is this. Okay, we shall see what it is. Now, first of all, in order to find it out, what A will do is, A will take its own IP address and its own subnet mask and do ANDing, right? Which means A will take its own IP address 200. So 200 is 11000001 0000001 2 0000001 2 0000001 0 0 1 0 and 10 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. So this is the IP address of A. A's IP address is this, and now it will take the subnet mask of A. I'm writing it in binary. 255 is all ones. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 255 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 255 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 255 dot 128. 128 is nothing but the starting bit is 1, which means 1 followed by 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So this is the IP address of A ending with subnet mask of A. Then what do I get? So this is 11001000, and this is 1234567 8, and this is 1234567 8, and this one is, if I AND it, I'm going to get 0000000, right? So it is nothing but the network ID of A according to A, which is, this is 200.1.2.0, which means this IP address belongs to the network 200.1.2.0, right? And similarly, it will take the subnet mask of A and AND it with IP address of B, right? Therefore, if I take the IP address of B is nothing but 200.1.2.130. 130, we I'm going to write it here. Okay, 10000010, right? This is 130. So now I'm going to AND IP address of B with the subnet mask of A. Then I am going to get network ID of B according to A, which means what will A think that location of B is, right? So we are going to get everything as same, but here it will be, if I AND these two, I am going to get 1 followed by 0000000, right? So which means this is nothing but 200.1.2.128, which means network ID of B according to A is, network ID of B according to A is 200.1.2.128. Now you understand it. Therefore, A will think that its network is 200.1.2.0 and B's network is 200.1.2.128. Therefore, A will send the packet to B, the router, and router is supposed to send it to B. Sometimes it is even worth noting that whatever A gets the conclusion, that may not be right, which means A and B might be present in the same network, but the subnet mask might give the illusion that B is present in the other network. Sometimes we do it intentionally because we don't want A to directly send a packet to B. Whenever A wants to send a packet to B, it is supposed to send the packet to the router, and router is going to send it to B. In case if it is present in the same network and we have given A an illusion that it is present in a different network, how can we make A believe that both are in different networks? By setting the subnet mask appropriately, isn't it? So whatever we got here is just an illusion how A thinks. It might not be right. The placement of actual physical placement of B might not depend on what is the subnet mask of A. Whatever we set the subnet mask of A as, A will think that only those many hosts are in its network, and if it wants to send a message to any other host which is not in the network, it will contact the router, and router will know where the B is, right? Either in the same network or in the different network, and accordingly router will forward it. It is just an illusion we are providing. So let's see, what if B's IP address is not this. B's IP address is, let us say B's IP address is 200.1.2.126. Then what will A think about B? I'm changing the IP address of B. B's IP address is, instead of this, I'm writing it as 126. Therefore, it is 0123456 0. So this is nothing but 126, right? 126. Now if I AND these two, I'm going to get this as 1234567 8, right? So now you understand this. So what did I do is, I have taken the subnet mask of A along with the IP address of B and I ANDed it. Now I got the network ID of B according to A as 200.1.2.0. Okay, therefore the network ID of B according to A is 200.1.2.0. Now you understand this. Now A thinks that its own network is 200.1.2.0 and B's network is 200.1.2.0. In this case, it will directly send a message to B. Got it? Therefore, that is why every host is also supposed to have subnet mask, even though it is not a router. Okay, the reason is it has to know whether to send a packet directly to the default gateway or to the destination, right? So we shall see one more example here. Understand the next one. IP address of A is 200.1.2.10 and subnet mask of A is 255.255.255.128 and IP address of B is 200.1.2.69 and subnet mask of B is 255.255.255.192. Now both are having different subnet masks and both are present in the IP address which is starting with 200. Now my question is, what will A think about B and what will B think about A? What, you know, according to their perception. So what is their perception? Their subnet mask, right? So according to their subnet mask, what will A think about B and what will B think about A? So for that, now A will do this. A will take its own IP address IA and it will land it with its own subnet mask. Then it is going to get network ID of A according to A, right? So what will this be? If I take IP address of A and AND it with subnet mask of A, if I AND these two numbers, what I get is, if I AND these two, I'm going to get 200.1.2. If I AND 10 and 128, it is going to be 0, right? You please check it. You can check it later. Next one is, A will take IP address of B and subnet mask of A and AND it. So if it ANDs both of them, what is it supposed to get is network ID of B according to A, right? So it is going to take the subnet mask of this one and it is going to AND it with IP address of B, right? So if I AND these two numbers, what I get is 200.1.2. If I AND 128 with 69, 128 and 69 is going to produce 0. You can check it, okay? Convert it to binary and you can check it. Now what will A think? Now A will think that according to A, network ID of A is 200.1.2.0 and according to B, network ID of A is 200.1.2.0. therefore A will think that both are present in the same network, okay? Now what about B? If I take IP address of B and subnet mask of B, right, and if I AND them, what we get is network ID of B according to B, right? So if I AND these two numbers, which is 64 and 192, and if I AND them, if I AND these two numbers, I'm going to get output as 200.1.2.64. you check it, okay? If I AND these two, it is going to be if you want to see what is 65 is 0100 and 0101. This is 65 and 192 is 11123456. Now if I AND these two, we are going to get 0112 3 4 5 6, right? Therefore it is 64, okay? And if I AND IP address of A with subnet mask of B, then output I am going to get is network ID of A according to B, right? So this number will be, if you AND these two, 192 and 10, you are going to get 0, which means 200.1.2.0, right? So now you understand this. According to A, both are in same network because both got the same network ID. But according to B, both are in different networks because they got different ID. How is it possible? According to A, they are in the same network, but according to B, they are in different network. How is it possible is because it is just a perception which is given by the subnet mask, which may not be true, and this nothing might be true, right? So one thing is, according to A, this subnet mask is saying that it is 128 is used, which means if you assume that it is class C, just for the sake of example, it need not be class C also, it could be classless, just to, you know, explain it in a simple way. According to A, this subnet mask dot 128 says that we are dividing it into two parts, According to B, this subnet mask .192 says that we are dividing it into four parts. Okay, that is the difference. Now, according to A, 0 to 127 are in one network and 128 to 255 are in other network. According to B, 0 to 63, 64 to 127, 128 to 191, 192 to 255. These are in one network, right? Therefore, according to A, 10 and 69 both are present in the same network. But according to B, 10 and 69 both are present in different networks. That is why, both will think differently. And moreover, one thing you should observe is, both of them might be in the same network in reality, but then using this subnet mask, assigning this subnet mask to A and B will make them think in a different manner. In reality, both of them could be in the same network, right? Now, if A wants to send a message to B, it will send it directly. The reason is A thinks that B is in the same network. If B wants to send a message to A, B will send it to a router, and again the router will send it back, the default gateway, right? So using this subnet mask, we have increased the security in the sense, now some of the hosts can never send a packet directly to other hosts. They will send the packet to router, and at router we can have something called as access control risk, and we can control the access to other hosts. Got it? So this subnet mask is just a perception, it is not reality. Okay. In most of your computers, if you type ifconfig or ipconfig, you will see that your subnet mask is this. You will see that your subnet mask is 255.255.255.255, right? So what is this subnet mask? This subnet mask, the number of zeros is zero, which means the host ID part is completely zero. So the subnet mask says that there are actually 2 power 0 hosts in this, which means it is not a valid subnet mask at all, right? The size of the block or network or subnet is 0 here, right? So what does it mean? Why do you think that they have given it? The reason is, if you take a connection using your modem, Airtel modem or Reliance modem, then you are having a point-to-point connection. You are not present in a network. You are having a point-to-point connection with your router, right? Therefore, whatever packet you have to send to the other host, you should always go through the router in order to make sure that you'll always go through the router without directly contacting any other host, even though the host is in your network, is to give you the subnet mask this. If they give you the subnet mask or 255, 255, 255, 255, what happens is, let us say your IP address is IA and your subnet mask is this one, right? So if you add your any number, any IP address with this, any number, if you add it with this number, you are going to get the same number as output, which means if you add this number with any number, you are going to get IA only, right? So therefore, it means that the network in which you are present in is nothing but your IP address. That is the meaning of it. So the network in which you are present in is your own IP address. Now, if you want to send a message to some other host, then you are going to take the same subnet mask. Subnet mask is 255, 255, all 255. And then let us say IB. And if you add them, you are going to get IB as the output, right? Which means any other IP address, if you try to find out the network ID, you will see the network ID of other IP addresses, that IP address itself, which means your network ID is your own IP address and some other's network ID is their own IP address, and both are obviously going to be different. So no, you will see that no other IP address in the world is going to be in your network. So using this mechanism, they made sure that you will definitely send a packet to router in order to send the packet to any other host always. Okay, so this is one kind of model why all ones is used in subnet mask. And the other question is, given a directed broadcast address, can you find out the network ID or can you find out the subnet mask? Let us say the directed broadcast address given is 200.1.15.255. So if you remember what is a directed broadcast address, in the host ID part, if I put all ones, that is directed broadcast address, right? So let us say this is the directed broadcast address of some network. It is not class C. Right, okay, don't think that it is a classful classification, it is classless classification. Now the question is, if this number is given as directed broadcast address, then what do you think is the subnet ID, or what do you think is the subnet mask? If this is the directed broadcast address, I'm just converting it into binary. Okay, 200, I'm just converting this entire thing into binary. 11000200.1 1 2 3 4 2 3 4 15 is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 and 255 is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, right? So this is the number given, and now they are saying that this is the directed broadcast address, and now you have to say what could be the network ID. So one thing you should remember is directed broadcast address contains all ones in the host ID part. Therefore, by looking at this number, no, this part is definitely not network ID, sorry, host ID. If this part would have been host ID, definitely there would have been ones here, right? Therefore, by looking at this number, you might think that this entire part is host ID. It is possible, right? Why? The reason is there are all ones in that part, and according to the definition of directed broadcast address, all ones indicate host ID part. Therefore, yes, you might be right that this is the host ID part. But one thing you have to observe is even this could also be host ID part. The reason is this one could be a part of network ID in a classless classification. Till this part it could be network ID, which means /20/21, and the remaining bits could be host ID part, or even this could be, even that number could also be the host ID, or even this part could be host ID, right? Therefore, all possible host IDs or all possible subnet mask is, one subnet mask possible is /20, 8 plus 8 16, 16 plus 4 is 20, assuming that till this 4 zeros it is network ID, and other possibility is /21, assuming that the next one is also network ID, other possibility is /22, so on. We get many answers, right? So given this as DBA, directed broadcast address, if they are asking you what could be the subnet mask or the network ID for this network, there could be many answers. The reason is simple. So all ones in the network, you know, in directed address DBA, there will be all ones in host ID part. Therefore, we are getting these many combinations. So anything is possible. Okay, there are many answers.